playing and having fun. We're Avengers.
Out in space, in the emptiness, you'll find large clouds of gas and dust. Some are left over from a dying star. Others are where newborn stars are. These mysterious clouds are called nebulae. There are several different kinds for you to see. Out in the expanse of our galaxy, we'll go on an epic journey. Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, the greatest phenomena you ever saw. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how.
I'm the Ring Nebula from the constellation Hera. I'm a ring-shaped cloud called a planetary nebula. I have nothing to do with planets, though. The name refers to how I look like a planet through a telescope. When some stars are nearing the end of their life, they throw off large shells of gas, creating an awesome sight. I'm what's left after my star had a very good long run. Your sun will probably create a planetary nebula when it's done.
I'm Orion, one of the brightest nebulae in your sky. In the Orion constellation, I can be seen with the unaided eye. I am a diffuse nebula, a very common kind. It means I'm extended and don't have boundaries well defined. I'm called an emission nebula, more particularly. A place where new stars form, a stellar nursery. Lighting up the cosmos, I'm where new stars are coming to life. A cloud of high temperature ionized gas, I emit my own light.
Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how.
I'm the Horsehead Nebula, you can find me in Orion. My cloud is shaped like a horse's head, I promise I ain't lying. I am what is known as a dark nebula type. I am a dark dense cloud that blocks out all the light. My cloud is so dense that I absorb all light behind me. A mysterious shadowy figure outlined by the light around me. Dark nebulae are extremely hard to find. It helps when there are bright stars or emission nebula nearby.
I'm the Pleiades Nebula, you can find me in Taurus. A large cluster of stars with a cloud of gas and dust. I have many names, Pleiades, Seven Sisters, and M45. I reflect the light of stars around me and nearby. Reflection Nebula, I don't make any light of my own. I rely on the star cluster I'm passing through to make my presence known. The light of the stars around me reflects off my dust particles, illuminating me in a way that makes me shine and sparkle.
Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how.
A fantastic sight to behold, I'm the Crab Nebula. You can find me in Taurus, an epic phenomena. When a massive star ends its life in a blaze of glory, it explodes in supernova, but that's not the end of the story. I'm a nebula type called a supernova remnant. I'm the material left over from a star's explosive event. Although my star may be gone, it will never be forgotten. As a supernova remnant, we live on to honor them.
You'll find large clouds of gas and dust. Some are left over from a dying star. Others are where newborn stars are. These mysterious clouds are called nebulae. There are several different kinds for you to see. Out in the expanse of our galaxy, we'll go on an epic journey. Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, the greatest phenomena you ever saw. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how.
I'm the Egg Nebula, a rare bizarre ripple in space. In the Cygnus constellation is where I find my place. A pre-planetary nebula, I'm just starting to take shape.
The dying star at my core still shedding its outer material away. Looking at me, you can see how a nebula is formed. My central star is still shining, but I won't be like this for long. I'll be a planetary nebula when my star is done, you'll see. And all that's left is a white dwarf core surrounded by the gases it released.
NGC 6302, or the Butterfly Nebula. A bipolar planetary nebula in the constellation Scorpius. I have one of the most complex structures of nebulas ever observed. My wings are extremely hot gases, tearing across the universe.
The Flame Nebula, a fire in the sky, blazing in the night. In the Orion constellation, I'll attack the third star in the belt to my right. A bright blue super giant that shines on me, which is why I burn so bright. An emission nebula in the Orion molecular cloud, a very popular sight.
Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now. Come with me, I'll show you how.
I'm watching you, an eye in the sky. I'm the Helix Nebula, look deep into my eye. I'm a planetary nebula, a perfect example to see. An expanding shell of gas around the dying star, that's me. I'm the first planetary nebula to be discovered to have thousands of cometary knots, also called globules. These tackle-shaped objects resemble comets, enormous objects that formed during my dying star's final phase. I'm in the constellation Aquarius, about 700 light-years away.
In the Ophiuchus constellation, I may look like a black hole in space. I absorb all light behind me. I'm Barnard 68. A dark molecular cloud or dark absorption nebula, I'm opaque, not clear. I obscure so many stars behind me, which means I'm closer to you than I appear.
I'm known as the Hand of God, and you can probably see why. I look like an enormous hand reaching out across the sky. I'm really a pulsar wing nebula after a supernova pulsar was left behind. It lights up my eerie shape in the constellation Cirsidus, you will find.
Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how.
In the constellation Dorado, far away in a large Magellanic cloud, I'm 30 Dorados, but you know me as the Tarantula. I look like a burrowing spider, surrounded by my silk strands. I'm where our star population expands. I'm an emission nebula, an incredible stellar nursery. Thousands of young stars have been forming inside of me. At my core, star cluster, starburst region, NGC 2070, has some of the most massive and luminous stars you'll ever see.
Out in space, in the emptiness, you'll find large clouds of gas and dust. Some are left over from a dying star. Others are where newborn stars are. These mysterious clouds are called nebulae. There are several different kinds for you to see. Out in the expanse of our galaxy, we'll go on an epic journey. Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, the greatest phenomena you ever saw. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how.
A diffuse emission nebula, I'm called the Eagle Nebula. You may ask why, because I look like an eagle with its wings spread wide. But I'm also home to one of Hubble's most famously photographed sites, the celestial wonders known as the Pillars of Creation. That's right. These pillars are more than just a beautiful sight in me. They contain eggs, evaporating gaseous globules, you see. Globs of gas that are hatching new stars, a stellar nursery. Discovered in 1745, the constellation Serpents is where you'll find me.
Well, I have many names, Caldwell 6 and NGC 6543, most commonly known as the Cat's Eye Nebula, first nebula studied spectroscopically. Scientists studied absorption and emission of light and radiation by me. Hubble captured images of me that are perfect. Please, stunning to see. Discovered in 1786, I'm one of the most complex nebula ever seen. I appear to have a bullseye pattern with at least 11 wings around me. They're spherical bubbles from my pulsing star ejecting its mass every 1,500 years or so. You can look into my cat's eye in the constellation Draco.
Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one it is a must. Let's
Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how.
A lion's head, a clown face, an Eskimo. No, I'm NGC 2392. I can look like a lot of different types of things to you. I'm actually a bipolar double-shell planetary nebula, you see. Discovered in 1787, find me in Gemini. Your son may end up just like me.
A waterfall nebula, stunningly beautiful and proud. In the Orion constellation, part of the Orion molecular cloud. Scientists are baffled by my origin and structure, of which little is known. My beauty is unparalleled, and my secrets are my own.
I'm NGC 6826, also known as Caldwell 15. A planetary nebula that looks like I blink. I have a bright white dwarf star at the center of me, surrounded by a greenish orb of gas that was ejected, you see. Stare directly at me and you'll only see my bright central star. Then look slightly to the side of me, suddenly you'll see the gas of my nebula. When you switch from looking straight on to averted vision, I blink off and on. Discovered in 1973, I'll wink at you from the Cygnus constellation.
Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meeting one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now. Come with me, I'll show you how.
I'm the Red Square Nebula, one of the most symmetrical celestial objects ever seen. I look like a large square surrounding two cones, you see what I mean? I have rungs in the cones, which suggests my central star erupts episodically. Discovered in 2007 by the Hale Telescope at the Palomar Observatory. I'm a bipolar nebula surrounding the star MWC 922, the bright center of my shape that makes me visible to you. My perfect symmetry suggests the space around me is very still, no stellar wind. You can see my mysterious shape in the constellation Serpent.
Out in space, in the emptiness, you'll find large clouds of gas and dust. Some are left over from a dying star. Others are where newborn stars are. These mysterious clouds are called nebulae. There are several different kinds for you to see. Out in the expanse of our galaxy, we'll go on an epic journey.
Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meanest one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how. Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meanest one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Let's go meet a nebula now, come with me, I'll show you how. Let's go meet a nebula, the coolest spectacle you ever saw. Incredible sculptures of gas and dust, meanest one, it is a must. Let's go meet a nebula, fantastic gaseous phenomena. Keep looking through your telescope to see who can make the next discovery.